No Film School's coverage of NAB 2019 is brought to you by Rode Microphones, the choice of today's creative generation. SERP, simple, portable motion control. Blackmagic Design, creating revolutionary solutions for film, post-production, and television.
Hey guys, this is Oakley from No Film School. I'm at NAB 2019. I'm here at the Zoom booth with Samuel. Sam, thanks for meeting with us to tell us about the new F6. So what is new?
So this is our latest field recorder. It has all of the features from our F-series that you'd expect, our highest quality preamps, time code generator built in, with a time code in and out as well. Multiple power options. We did switch it up for this unit, obviously, which has a small form factor. We think an external battery doesn't make a lot of sense. It adds so much bulk. So we threw an L-series battery sled on there. And with the multiple capacities of those, you can really power it all day. On top of that, you have the AA batteries for backup, as well as being able to power through the USB-C port. One line output and one headphone output with six inputs. Really in a nice small package. It's so easy to take with you and record anywhere. But the real exciting stuff is actually internal. This is our first implementation of a dual AD converter, which allows us to expand the dynamic range so much that you can't clip the preamps. Your microphone will clip before that happens. Combine that with the ability to record 32-bit float files. So 24-bit files have been standard for a long time. They sound great. But they're not without their negatives, and we've all experienced it. With 32-bit float, the entire dynamic spectrum is recorded with an equal quality. When they change their volumes, there's no need to adjust the gain because there would be no effect on the audio quality. All you have to do is change the fader level for your mix. So as a result, if you're recording in the 32-bit float mode, there's no need to set gain at all. If you have the microphone plugged in and you hit the record button, you will get good audio. So the files are saved post-fader. Again, something that doesn't make a lot of sense for 24-bit, because if we bring a file in that the fader was turned down into our DAW, and we try to turn it up, the audio is, you know, useless. 32-bit float, however, if you take two files recorded into here, one where the fader was at a normal level and one where it was turned all the way down, load them into your DAW, you'll see one waveform from the normal fader level, and the other one you'll see nothing. But when you normalize both of those files, they sound exactly the same. You can record a 32-bit float and 24-bit simultaneously in case you need to hand that SD card and you're not sure if somebody will be able to handle it. But all the major programs already handle 32-bit float files.
So when you're recording in the field in 32-bit float, does it change how you set the levels? Are there limitations you have to work with in that sense? Or like, how does it change that part?
No, it's really, it makes it more hands-off than ever before. The six knobs on the front just control the faders. Obviously, you don't need to use a limiter if you're not worried about clipping. So it really is just plug it in, hit record, and then work the faders, and you're good to go. Now, output-wise, one-line output allows you to go to a camera and the headphones. You know, it is a form factor, and it will come with a bracket that makes it easy to mount under a camera if you're a DSLR shooter. You know, not worrying so much about what's going on during recording, knowing that in post-production you will definitely have audio that you'll be able to manipulate the way you want, takes a lot of the worry out of the process.
Absolutely. And so for the six inputs, how many channels can you record that onto?
Sure. So you can record the six inputs plus a stereo mix made by the by your fader settings while the recording is happening.
So what's the price point on the F6, and when does it become available?
So it will be available in June. We do not know the price point right now. In May, we expect we'll be able to release the manual with full details as well as the pricing.